Joe Breezy and the Up All Night Show.
107.9
PM. Make some noise for Bow Wow.
Yeah. What's
up? How you doing, man?
I'm good, man. I couldn't be better.
Now, you actually got here early, which I was very surprised, very pleasantly surprised. Now, you went to Target.
Yeah.
What was it like at Target? Like, what do you, can you just go to Target like me? Like, normally?
Oh, yeah. Well, I try my best.
Right.
I try my best, too.
That's good. You happen to a Target.
Target is like my favorite store to go into.
So how's everything going, man? How's everything going with you?
Everything's good, man. We got the brand new single out right now. You can get it all. It's going to be a big record for me. I'm excited about it. It's my 7th album.
Right.
Album's coming out March 31st, New Jack City Part 2. It's crazy, man. And I don't really like to say features. It's co-stars.
Okay.
I got co-stars in the album. T.I., Wayne, T-Pain, Trey Songz, Ron Browse. Swiss Beats. The list just goes on and on and on. So yeah, it's
funny when you say that you've had 7 albums. To me and to some other people, you'll kind of always be 15.
Yeah.
Isn't he still Lil Bow Wow? But obviously, you're a grown ass man now with 7 albums.
Yeah, that's great. That means when I get 50, I will still
be 15.
Oh, yeah.
That's a great problem to have.
I love it.
So, do you, I mean, 7 albums, do you, I mean, obviously, you kind of feel yourself evolving. Mm-hmm. I mean, do you feel that you have to evolve with your music, or does that just come naturally as you grow up?
It just comes naturally, honestly. I think that's what's so dope about being young and being an artist, the fact that I have an advantage over a lot of other artists, because I will continue to learn more stuff. I will continue to see more, and that'll be new information for my fans because they're my age and younger and they're growing up with me.
Right.
So I think that it's just a natural progression, honestly.
So coming full swing, obviously, kind of starting off with JD and then coming back, obviously, you know, you and him working together on the album, the single and everything. I mean, what's it like reuniting with JD?
Man, it's magic because nobody knows me like he does. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Even from an artist standpoint, every number one record that I've had, it's been something that he's produced. Only one of my records went number one that he didn't produce, and that was I'm a Flirt, which I was hands-on with that project, and a good friend of mine at the time was produced that record. But he just has that sound. He knows that sound. And Jermaine even feels that anybody who tries to work with me and the other producers, is they're trying to imitate basically what we did, so why go do that when you could just go home and get the real thing?
So are you, like, contractually signed to him, like, still? Or, I mean, if you don't mind me asking.
Yeah, no, not at all. Not contractually, no. But I'm still Columbia, you know, Sony artist. But Jermaine is, you might as well say So Def, because I got it tattooed on my arm. That's where it comes from.
Right, no
doubt. He's like my mentor slash pops, my big bro, everything, you know what I mean? So it's just the love.
So the single, You Can Get It All, obviously blowing up. I love the record.
Thanks.
Ladies love the record.
Oh, yeah. The ladies love it. That's it.
And that's what counts.
Oh, yeah.
How did it come about? How did the song come about?
Well, everybody knows Jermaine. He produced a lot of TLC records. And I told him that I wanted to come out with something different. I told him that I wanted to come out, because after Out of My System, I haven't really had, like, a big pop record since, like, Out of My System or, like, a Like You type of record. Mm-hmm. And I told him that I want my first single has to be different. And it's hard on artists when you have so many albums and so much material, because you have to really reinvent yourself. Because you have so much material, you can easily make a record that could have sound like the last album, the last single they come off the album. So I told him I wanted to have a more singy type of melodic type of feel to it. A real bona fide, like, I need that pop record. I need that sound. Like, that's the sound I'm reaching for. And he came, he told me to go in the studio, lay it. And when I heard it, I was like, oh, this is crazy.
Yo,
I was like, I got to do it. This is the money right here.
So is there ever times where, like, he has something that you hear and you're like, man, I got to get on that. But for whatever reason, it goes to somebody else? Or is there something that you want to do, or maybe that he wants you to do, but it just doesn't, like, you know, fit for you maybe at the time?
Oh, man, it's been so many records that Jermaine has done, and I've witnessed a lot of the records that I'm sure you guys have played that I've been like, oh, let me get
beat. Yeah, let me get that
one. Man, please let me get that record bad.
That must be tough sometimes.
It is, because I can just hear myself on it,
and
I get so, like, I was in the studio when he made Usher's My Boo, when he did that.
Huge song, needless to say.
Huge record, like, number one record, and I'm like, oh, that beat, JD, that's me. Yeah. For the girls, that's my... And he gave it away, so I was like, ah, man. But it's so many records like that, though.
Yeah, that's awesome, man. Now, you're actually doing some more movies.
Correct.
Right? Tell us about them.
Yeah, well, as far as the acting thing is concerned, everybody's talking about Entourage. I'm back on Entourage.
Okay.
We start filming in April.
Yeah.
Aside from that, I got a brand new movie grade come out, like, end of the summer. It's called Hurricane Season, starring myself, Forrest Whitaker, Taraji Henson, who's just up for an Oscar.
Right.
And Lil Wayne is in the movie as well. Wayne is in the movie. He does his thing, so... Yeah, it's going to be real hot.
Man, that's awesome. Is it tough for you to choose, like, music, movies, or you just kind of balance it with your schedule?
Yeah, I balance it with my schedule. I mean, everything really plays out, you know, however I wanted to. You know what I'm saying? And I think that that's what's so dope is people just work nonstop for me and working around the clock and just working around the schedule trying to fit things in. Like, I'm going to be filming Entourage while I'm in the middle of a promotional tour.
Right.
So, like, just trying to cram all of this stuff in, but it's only right that you get started on these type of things months prior so you don't run into that yeah. type of problem.
Now, your birthday's actually on Monday, right?
Yeah, 22.
Man, what are you do for your birthday?
Vegas.
Just take over a club, just whatever. Yeah. Does somebody else make the plans for you and you just show up and rock it?
That's what it is. I mean, you get the industry is so small, man. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, even last year when I did it on MTV, I did my stunt in 21.
Right, remember that.
That wasn't my idea to actually have the party in Vegas. You know, they just contacted me like, he has to come here. We want to give him everything.
And you're like, all right, I'll go to Vegas for 21st.
If y'all want
to
give me everything, 10 grand, I can gamble with. That ain't my money, that's y'all money. I'm coming. You know what I'm saying? I don't care if it was in the mountains. I'm going. If it's y'all taking care of everything, I'm there. So, you know what I mean? So when they told me that, you know, I wanted to go and I always wanted to gamble in Vegas. Yeah. It's been so many times I went to Vegas with Nelly and JD. And they always be like, you can't stand on the carpet. You got to stand behind
and
the carpet.
And you're all, what? It's right there. Let
I'm like, man, I got
there.
More money than
than that guy.
Half the people in the casino. Come on, man. So, but, you know, now it's cool and it's all love. So I'm going to be celebrating my birthday again
in Vegas. So what's your drink of choice, man? What do you drink?
Actually, I don't drink at all. I don't drink alcohol.
Really?
Mm-mm.
So that actually is Gatorade? That is
yes.
G? It's yes. not a, you're not drinking vodka and
what's
G at 10 a.m.?
What's G? Yeah, this is it right here. I can't. I have like a bad, like my stomach. I have like stomach issues, so it's hard for me to like.
Yeah, have you had like a bad experience with alcohol?
That's exactly why.
So, you got to tell us about that, man.
Patron.
We all have.
That
really?
Is the devil's juice.
Man.
Patron is the devil.
Patron.
Man, you got to. Jamie's right. That right there made me stop drinking. I keep liquor in my condo, but it's more or less for guests than myself. Because every time they come over, like, y'all could have sworn to God I seen that Grey Goose bottle and it was still the same amount when I was here like 4 months ago.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, yeah.
That's cool, man. So I got to ask, and I'm, you know, the whole Chris Brown and Rihanna thing, obviously allegations, two sides every story, pictures came out. And I also know that, you know, you also have to answer it kind of politically correct. Like, for real, what are your real thoughts on everything?
Well, first and foremost, I just spoke to Chris yesterday.
Okay.
I speak to Chris all the time. I mean, that's my friend. You know what I'm saying? And he knows that it's so, and I just feel for him because at the same time, he hasn't been convicted. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
and you know, you got a lot of people pointing fingers of, well, he did that. Well, we wasn't really there. We don't know what happened. You know what I mean? We don't
so
know.
So what did he tell you that you can share with us that he told you?
I mean, I wouldn't talk about you know, what we talked about just because that is my friend and, you know, it's real personal information. But all I can tell you is this, is that when you're entertaining, and especially when you're in a high-profile relationship, this is why I can kind of feel for the situation.
Yeah, with you and all that stuff.
Exactly.
Yeah, totally.
And that alone is pressure. You know what I'm saying? And then by them being young, it's hard to have pressure on a young person anyway. It's just hard to deal with. So you got the blogs that are putting pictures, running stories, trying to tell you what they think is going on. But at the end of the day, none of us was really there, so it's really hard for us to judge. All we can say is that I don't condone putting my hands on a female, and I think that that's the wrong thing to do. But I also feel like it's the wrong thing to do for me to conversate on something that I wasn't really there. So I just really wish them both the best, and I hope that they can get back on their 2 feet and get back to doing what we love them for doing, and that's dropping hot records, entertaining the fans, and doing what we love for them to do, and that's being them. So I pray for them both.
Right, no doubt. So are they back together? I mean, did they confirm that?
I don't know.
Okay. All right, I understand. All right, so back to you, man. So what could we look for? Obviously, the album. Tell us about the album once again.
New Jack City Part 2, March 31st. It's going to be crazy. Man, Scream Tour. I'm back on the Scream Tour this summer, so we definitely going to be coming back here for the tour.
That's always huge.
It's going to be crazy, man. So I'm just excited to be here. I got my basketball sneaker coming out in the fall.
Okay.
Vroom Athletics, that's me. I call myself Mr. Lamborghini Moss.
So
the Vroom comes from the Lambo taking off.
I get it. That's
awesome.
You
know what I mean? So just a whole bunch of stuff in the works that I'm doing. So I just can't wait to go ahead and see all this stuff happening.
There
so,
we go. Bow Wow, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
Now,
that's how it's
going
down.
The fans that want to get in touch with you, how can they get in touch with you?
YouTube.com/PrinceBowWow.
Okay. Are you on Twitter? Can people follow you on Twitter?
You know what? Somebody asked me that yesterday about Twitter. Yeah. And the only reason why I'm not on there is because I don't understand it. Because you can't really post a lot. It's like quick stuff.
It's like quick stuff like, hey, I'm in traffic. Da, da, da.
Yeah, that's
like
it.
I just posted right now, Bow's at Target coming back. We're going to do an interview.
Right.
So, like, you know.
But there's like, so then if they want to know more, you got to post
you
another
can, like,
quick...
You can, like, post a link, like, a picture. Like, right now, I can be like, oh, you know, I'm hanging out in the studio with Bow Wow, boom, take a picture of you, send it up.
See, that's not
and
enough.
My followers.
I like for them to see me. That's why I like doing the YouTube, the video. I keep my Flip It with me everywhere I go.
There we go.
And I update it daily, so... And I'm the number one musician on YouTube, so it works.
There we go.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bow Wow, once again, appreciate you stopping by and hanging out with the Up All Night Show, man.
Not a problem, man. Thanks for having me, man. Always a pleasure.
Joe Breezy and the Up All Night Show.
107.9 The End.